Let's start off with plate racks. These are like open shelves, but 100 times harder to clean. So all of you out there who absolutely hate the open shelf trend, and I know there's many of you, you're absolutely not like the plate rack. At one point in history, the plate rack seemed like a good idea. But from my thinking, it's the least functional thing we could have ever hung on a wall. See, at least an open shelf is somewhat versatile. If I want to put a plate there, I can. If I want to put a mug there, I can. If I want to put some decorations there, I can. But with a plate rack, I'm pigeonholed into one thing. I can only store plates. So for me, this is a lot of real estate invested into one item that I have to dedicate an entire cabinet for. I personally just don't like the look of it, but that's not the reason it's on my bad trend list. I just don't think it's that functional. And to make matters worse, what we've done is we've added hooks and stemware holders so that we can hang mugs and hang glasses. Like, this is making it any better. So now your plate rack cabinet looks like a cluttered mess. A much better solution for your plates is to put them in a drawer or a cabinet inside one of these handy plate holders. These expand to just about any size plate that you're gonna have in your kitchen. They're easy to carry. You can take out all your plates, put them on, say, your island. If you have company, everyone can grab a plate, dish up their meal. So these are very versatile. I'll link to these below in the description. You can check them out. There's a variety of different ones. This is made by Blum. It's a really, really good quality plate holder. This is a much better solution, in my opinion, than the plate rack. If you're familiar with me, you know that I don't like corner cabinets at all. But what I don't like even more are lazy Susans. I just don't like the idea of something falling off the back of that lazy Susan to now a space that's blocked by this appliance that I can never get at without some, at least, discomfort on my part. I realize that the lazy Susan and the corner cabinet space is great space for storage. Okay, I get it. But it's so deep, hands and knees, you're digging in there, something falls off the back, it's basically lost forever, let's face it. The NKBA has a guideline, number 29, in fact, that says that a kitchen should have at least one corner cabinet with a functioning storage device. And I just am very perturbed by this. People have commented and have reached out and said, yes, the lazy Susan, the corner cabinet must go. It is the least functional space in the kitchen. There's gotta be a better way. Okay, so you have a corner cabinet and you have a lazy Susan. What are you supposed to do, rip the thing out? In a perfect world, I'd say yes. Block off your corner and make the ends of that unit more functional with drawers or anything else. But I realize you can't do that. I realize you may not want to do that. And I realize you might think I'm crazy for even suggesting that you block off a corner. So if you're gonna have a lazy Susan, at least look at these items, which are these triangular baskets that are made to fit on a lazy Susan. These are a relatively inexpensive fix. Check out the description below for some links that I have for some of these baskets that might be right for you. If you're stuck with the corner lazy Susan, at least try to make it as most functional as you can. Over the range microwaves have to be the worst idea that have ever entered the kitchen. Yet for many years, we've seen the barrage of these appliances showing up in kitchen designs and kitchens all over the globe. And I'm guilty of it myself. I designed kitchens for many years and it was just automatic. You would put an over-the-range microwave right above every stove. The more you think about it, the more you realize this is not the greatest use of that space for a couple reasons. Especially if you have a family, the appliance is way too high. The NKBA guidelines for microwaves says that a microwave that's on a shelf should be no higher than 54 inches off the floor. As a reference, 54 inches is the bottom of your wall cabinet. The same guideline manual says that for a vent hood over a stove should be no more than 60 inches off the floor. So right away we have this discrepancy in the guidelines. The two things just shouldn't go together. They've never really made a microwave that has enough venting power to really suck enough air out of the room. They've gotten better over the years, but I've still never seen one that really does the job like a traditional range vent hood. And one of the problems is because you can vent these things inside themselves so that the air blows back into your kitchen, they're just a microwave. They're not really venting anything. They're just circulating air, but that air is just pumping back into your kitchen. It's not getting out of your house. And every kitchen needs to have good ventilation. You got to get that moisture and that air out of there. So it's very, very important that one, you have a vent hood, and two, It's vented outside. To change out this appliance, it's not that easy. I understand that. So here's my solution. It's not the easiest one, but this is what I think you should do when you're considering changing out that appliance. If in fact you are, get a range hood and get yourself a countertop microwave. Or forget the microwave altogether and find yourself an air fryer or something else that seems to be more popular right now. You know what? Here's a good idea. You know that plate rack cabinet that I say you should get rid of? Rip those dowels out of that plate rack cabinet and maybe put your microwave in there. It's the perfect height. It's probably at 54 inches off the floor as it is right now. You'll thank yourself for investing in proper ventilation. Find the one that draws the most air possible. Don't worry about these features about how quiet they are. Listen, the thing isn't running 24 hours a day. It runs when you need it to run and then you turn it off. So for me, I don't care how loud that thing is. I just want all that stuff vented out of my house. So when I turn on my range hood, I can hear it. It's sucking the curtains off the walls, but that's what I want. And I don't care how loud that is for the moments that I'm using it. Find one that draws the most amount of cubic feet of air per minute out of your home. That's the main feature you want to look for. Get rid of that microwave, you'll be glad you did. As I move around for this next shot, I'd just like to say thank you. Please give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you like my content. Thanks. Let's talk about the hanging pot rack. This is in the same category as the plate rack cabinet and the open shelf. It's just a hanging dust collector normally above your island. And I get what we're trying to do with the hanging pot rack. We're trying to find the unused spaces in our kitchens and make them so that they're more functional. So why not use the space above our islands that's just there doing nothing and hang a great big pot rack there? And I'm not even against what they look like. I in fact kind of think they look rather eclectic. And that's just me. But the functionality of them, I'm just not there with. Of course, if you're starving for space in your kitchen and you need to use one of these, then go for it. It's a great space to hang pots on. However, there's a better solution for pots out there, and that's to put them in a deep pot drawer or to get some kind of pull-out accessory that you can stack your pots in and your lids, because those are a real issue, that is easy to access, that's close to your range. Now, in a medium to large kitchen, this is not that big a deal to do. So I understand that in a small space, when you're trying to maximize every square inch that you can, that yes, putting a pot rack above your island or hanging them somewhere might be a good idea. If you don't like dust and having to clean more items, then I definitely don't recommend this. Especially for all you people out there that are dead set against the open shelf and probably don't like this plate rack idea either, the hanging pot rack, you definitely don't want to have. The kitchen desk, I think it's safe to say that we're happy that this trend is not really something that we do anymore. Have you ever seen a kitchen desk that wasn't just completely cluttered with junk? Maybe when it's first installed, but after that, after life, after you start living in your kitchen, these things are just magnets for clutter and mess. Who needs a desk in their kitchen in the first place? Like, who thought they'd be actually sitting down using the desk as a functioning desk in their kitchen? Please let me know, is it just a magnet for all of your clutter, or do you actually use it as a desk like it's supposed to be used? From what I've seen, from what I hear from people, it doesn't get used that way, and it's much better off if we had have taken that space and made it into something more functional like a pantry. Nobody wants to be sitting down at a desk anyway with a cabinet stuck in their face with just a little bit of room where their knees don't fit underneath because the drawer is too deep and you can't get a chair to fit it. I don't think they're the greatest idea. We need to take that space and use it much better, and I think we can by just adding storage. This brings me to the raised lunch counter, which you can check out in this video right here. Also, no list would be complete without this video, the worst kitchen trend of all time. Check out that video if you want to find out what it is. Thank you for watching, liking, and hopefully subscribing. Bye.